मैडम डिप्टी चेयरमैन फ्रॉम द स्पीचेस विच द हॉनरेबल मिनिस्टर फॉर प्लानिंग मेड इन दिस हाउस एंड इन द अदर हाउस एंड फ्रॉम अ परजुअल ऑफ द नोट विच हैज़ बीन सर्कुलेटेड टू अस रिगार्डिंग द प्रोग्रेस दैट हैज़ बीन मेड इन द 10th फाइव ईयर प्लान एंड द वेरियस स्टेटमेंट्स ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट एंड द प्लानिंग कमीशन. आई हैव अ फीलिंग दैट द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज ट्राइंग टू अस्यूज द फीलिंग ऑफ डिससेटिस्फैक्शन इन द कंट्री थ्रू प्रोमिसेस ऑफ ब्राइट फ्यूचर, प्रोमिसेस ऑफ बेटर एफर्ट्स एंड जनरल promise that everything is going to turn out all right and that there need not be in any fear or anxiety in the country. Madam, while saying this, I realize that the country has made certain progress in the development of our economy during the last decade. Industrial production has increased, agricultural production has increased, the productive capacity has been built up and we have also got employment opportunities being created. Above all, we have gained valuable experience in the development of our economy, especially in planning, and these are all to the credit side of the plan. Unfortunately, madam, the price that we have paid for this progress is rather heavy. The imbalances that we have created are likely to go out of control unless definite steps are taken to see that the imbalances are corrected at the earliest opportunity. The problem of the distribution of income that is generated as a result of the development efforts in the country is a perennial question and comes up again and again in one form or the other before this house, and though I realize that no definite opinion is possible unless we have got some authoritative data and analysis on the subject, there is clear indication of the fact that if not economic wealth, at least economic power is being concentrated in fewer and fewer hands. As long as economic power is concentrated in such few hands, it will not be possible for us to develop in the manner in which we like, whatever may be our regulatory and control apparatus, whatever may be our policy, whatever may be the objectives that we place before the country. Similarly, the imbalance between the rural and the urban sector is also increasing. I do not know whether in the rural areas some income has been pumped in as a result of our planned development.